Santa Claus!
Ho, 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 ho!
Decibel Geek TV presents the Kuhn Brothers Rockcast. And here's your hosts, Pete and Jim, the Kuhn Brothers.
So then I wanted to take the fucking red scarf viewers and just
break his neck.
Why? Yeah, exactly.
Why would you?
I just hate him. Anyway, hey!
Oh,
episode 17!
Hey, welcome to episode 17 of the Kuhn Brothers Rockcast on Decibel Geek TV.
She's only...
On YouTube.
17.
She's only 17.
On YouTube.
And what is Kip saying now? She's only
47.
35.
No, because we were like 17 back then.
So no, but
she's only 47.
Remember we guessed. We don't always guess.
It's like 46. Yeah, 47.
It was like 46. He's up to 35 is what we heard maybe 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah, back then it was 35.
And we just always try to guess what year he's going to sing.
And he still doesn't know our names.
Yeah.
10, that was like 15 years ago and he still doesn't know our names.
He, yeah.
God love him.
But then he did go Pete and Jim.
You guys mixed,
mixed up
deliberately.
I don't care.
Anyway, welcome to the show. We're going to talk about Winger.
We got some killer announcements. Wolfpack. Let's start off with thanking our sponsor, Wolfpack Productions, because they're bringing some amazing shows to town.
2019 looks like it's going to be a spectacular year for Wolfpack and fans.
Yeah, which means us.
Yeah, we're fans.
Yeah, because we're fans and we're friends and we're lucky.
And we're proud of them because, holy shit, the lineup is coming fast and furious.
Yeah, and this is what happens at the end of the year usually. It's like Christmas presents to all Wolfpack people.
And it's really cool because Pete and I aren't right now. As of right now, we're not going on the cruise next year.
Right.
This coming February.
Right, as of right now.
But Wolfpack keeps bringing the bands.
From the cruise.
It's lessening the blow a little bit, as she said.
Yeah.
As they said.
As you said.
You said. Your mom.
No, that's my mom. Your mom is
terrible.
You can't do that. You can't do the mom thing.
I hate that.
Yeah, not cool. So welcome to episode 17. What a way to start. It's our Christmas episode. Happy holidays to everyone. And a shout out to our Jew friends.
A shout out to the...
China! Do it right.
Hanukkah. We're Jewish. We can do that.
We're part Jewish.
And
right?
That's why we can make Hitler jokes too.
No, we're not allowed to make Hitler jokes.
We are because we're Jewish. Our mom was Jewish.
We can make Jewish jokes, penny like jokes and stuff.
I can make.
So
jokes
shout
about...
out to Scott Elpern, one of my favorite Jewish friends, who just rag on Jews all the time as like because he is Jewish. He would. I got the funniest jokes.
That's right. We make fun of bankrolls, Jewish bankrolls. There's all sorts of Jewish jokes.
I always felt guilty. We were Jewish.
It was
but
okay.
I still felt dirty and guilty.
We don't make any Christian jokes.
So, either. I know it looks Christmassy, and we love Christmas.
We celebrate Christmas. We're Jewish, we celebrate Christmas.
But we also celebrate...
So, happy holidays.
Hanukkah. Just because I like to get the phlegm up every once in a while.
Happy Kwanzaa. And Merry Cholula.
Diwali.
I love this.
Do you know Diwali?
I do. It's an animal, I think.
Diwali is a celebration in India. That goes around the
zoo. I thought it looked like an antelope. I thought it was one of those antelopes that kind of hop around the zoo.
No, it could be their logo, though. No.
No?
No. Is that a real animal?
Yeah.
Something like sounds like
no,
that?
No, I think it is.
Right? I think he's thinking of a koala bear, is what he's thinking.
A shout out to all of our
friends that celebrate
ethnic
holidays.
And non-ethnic friends.
And don't celebrate. That's fine, too.
Nice to see you, Muhammad.
While Jim finishes his shot because he's a wuss, I will tell you that we're coming back in about 30 seconds with the perfect 10, but it's not...
Christmas version! And it might not be 10, we have to figure out...
You keep talking. La 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 la.
He stole my songs. So I will have to come back to you with some new songs. We will get there for this Christmas.
Oh, it's delicious. Be back in a second. Christmas style, and we have 10 songs, 5 each, that we think envelop the
spirit of Xmas.
Of Xmas in rock and roll style, right?
And so, rock and roll and musical.
And I gotta be honest, one of my songs.
This is a rock cast, but I mean, Honestly, I give you music that I love and like, and some of it's...
So give us some leeway. Jim's going to start us off tonight.
Yeah, so this is as rock and roll as it gets. And we're going to go, okay, so I got two choices for King Diamond. And the song I love the most is called Christmas. It's off of Puppet Master, the 2003 album Puppet Master. It's called Christmas. It does like a little drummer boy intro in the beginning, and it's really mellow, and then all of a sudden it like goes into the depths of hell, and it's the greatest song. No, really. But
like
the one
he does.
But the one that you're probably more familiar with is from his 1986 album Fatal Portrait. And it's actually a bonus track on that album. If you got that album when it first came out, it wasn't available. But as that, then he made this
CD and released it.
And
that's the one I'm familiar with.
No Presents for Christmas. And that's where you're going to see a live version of No Presents for Christmas. It's so awesome. King is the greatest. And it's just, it's so... The juxtaposition of King Diamond next to Christmas is insane. So this is from 1986. It's a bonus track on Fatal Portrait. This is No Presents for Christmas.
I know, and I was honestly, that's why I did that with the pen. I crossed that off my list because that's one of mine too. So, but I had extra two just in case because we did cross over with two, right? You hear the song that I picked right now,
Get On With It,
which is Dokken.
Get On With It.
So, Dokken does a version of Santa Claus Is Coming to Town, and this is Don's voice at its, you know, really strong point. So
like that's like 15 years ago.
And I don't love these songs being redone. I mean, I don't like the songs anyway. I don't love Christmas music. I'm not like I'm listening to the Christmas station all
I hate that.
Like for 3 months. I hate that. I don't even like it. It's fine if I'm going into a store shopping and stuff and I hear some
if you hear it in your car, it reminds you I have to go shopping.
Yeah,
there's so much shopping left to do.
Right, and then just if you're stressed out, you have to take a Xanax.
Yeah, I hate Christmas.
But we love this Christmas song. This is Dokken's version of Santa Claus Is Coming to Town, and I think it rips.
That was kick-ass, and Dokken's coming to Denver, and we're going to talk about that when we talk about
see the whole graphics
all of our
wall,
beautiful
Wolfpack shows.
God, every band I talk about is like, well, Wolfpack's
Well, they're coming. Yep, Wolfpack's bringing them.
Yeah, living in Denver is really killer these days.
Straight out of Denver, baby.
Straight up. All right, second song of mine is from one of our favorite bands on the show. We love Skid Row.
Yeah.
And they do a lot of Christmas songs live. And I think this one you're going to see, I don't think this is Sebastian. I think this is one of the other singers that I don't
know. Tony Hornell.
No, it wasn't Tony.
No.
Did they have another good blonde guy, too, before? Sebastian, before Tony.
Yeah.
I think it was another blonde dude. Kicks ass. Jingle Bells.
Yeah, he was only with him for like 12 years, and I can't remember his name because I'm an idiot.
Well, it's okay, though. Here's Skid Row Jingle Bells, which is number two on my list.
Cool. All right, so I'm going way back for this next one. Way back.
On the way back machine.
Okay, on the way back machine. Turn it. Turn it for me,
who,
Jim.
Who's the way back machine?
Who did that?
It was a cartoon, wasn't it? Like a dog and a guy. Sherman.
Oh, and wow. Dog. Another ahead. Cartoon I can't remember.
You know what I'm talking about.
Short-term memory loss.
You know what I'm talking about!
So, back in the days of MTV in the 80s, we got to watch videos and you know, you saw the greatest rock bands and you got to see in some bands that would have probably never become popular without MTV. But this guy, Billy Squier, would have been popular anyway. The coolest thing about this video is that it has a whole bunch of celebrities, including all the MTV personalities, walking around at the end in hats. And who's in it? My favorite, one of my favorite celebrities of all
time. Paul Rubens.
Otherwise known as Pee-wee Herman. I love Pee-wee. And so the song is called Christmas is the Time to Say I Love You. And it's a really
cool
original
song. So wait, when you say MTV personalities, are you talking about Triple J?
I'm talking about Triple J and Nina Black.
You're talking about Martha?
Martha Quinn. Oh, man, did I do things...
Alan?
Alan Hunter. You're trying to get me.
Let's do this.
This is the four original MTV VJs in this video with Pee-wee Herman and Billy Squier and a bunch of other celebrities you might recognize. This is Christmas is the Time to Say I Love You.
Ooh.
I'm telling you,
it's a classic.
Come on, if you know it bring you back, that didn't bring you back to like.
No, it did.
Well, if you're older than us, it brought, or younger than us, it brought you back to when you were like five. But if you're about our age, it brought you back to when you were a teen.
That one, actually, I like. I can't rag on that one. I'll wait till you get to one of your other ones, or mine. I mean, mine aren't. Ugh. Okay. So I was checking out Christmas songs today, and I figured let's put this one three on my list. So Twisted Sister has a whole Christmas album. And it's the whole thing is really bad, but it's good because it brings back good memories.
Yeah,
and it's excellent.
Oh, that joke again.
So, I liked "Let It Snow." They have a great version of "Let It Snow." Actually, it's total the epitome of Dee Snider. You know, the stereotypical Dee Snider. But the one that you're gonna watch is easier to find
for rock and roll. It's all about. Helping Rock and Ron.
This week, I did my homework.
It's a Christmas present to Rock and Ron.
Yep, this week is what I just said. And Oh Come All Ye Faithful. Not Hateful.
Hateful? That'd be funny. We should write a song.
Oh Come All Ye Hateful.
Oh, jeez, wow. That's got some
triple entendre. Wow, this is Freudian slip.
Yeah, slippery and Freudian.
My wife used to wear one of those.
A Freudian slip? Yeah, she was great in it.
Hey!
Oh, sorry. I didn't see it.
So here's Oh Come All Ye Faithful in the tune of We're Not Gonna Take It. It's really bad, but Merry Christmas.
You gotta love Christmas. Kuhn Brothers style. Decibel Geek TV style.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
right?
Like, we don't have style. What are you talking about?
No, we have style. So do all our...
Sure I do. Well,
so do all our other Decibel Geek brothers and sisters. I wonder if they're doing Christmas shows.
In Canada. They don't have Christmas in Canada.
You know that they don't have Thanksgiving in Canada. They have Christmas in Canada.
They have Thanksgiving. It's just a month early.
So are Wallygator and Rich going to do, the Meister going to do a Christmas show?
Not only are they going to do a Christmas show, not only are they going to do a Christmas show, but I expect them to do a Boxing Day show.
Oh, a Boxing Day show.
If they don't do a Boxing Day show, and they are not giving,
I'll watch that
they are not giving props to their mother country. The home mother.
I agree.
The home mom. What do you call it? The mother country.
Mother, the mother country.
That's Russia.
Oh, sorry. speaking of mother country, Christmas is Sarajevo. Christmas Eve in Sarajevo.
Is that a song on your list?
It is, but it's not the song I want to play, but it's...
Oh, because that was like a good segment.
I know.
I didn't say it on your list.
It is right here.
Oh, it is on your
list. It is on my list. Trans-Siberian Orchestra, how can you not pass them up? Okay, first of all...
No, how can you pass them up?
How can you not? Oh, how can you pass them up? Yeah thanks. Yeah. Oh, yeah. This one's called Carol of the Bells, and Ron's going to start about 40 seconds into this song because that's the perfect point to start off. And I'm trying to give him his Christmas present right now. Trans-Siberian
Orchestra. Is it live?
Yeah, live.
So you've checked this out?
Yeah.
You know that it'll be easy
for watch it regularly.
Really? Even during Christmas?
While I'm decorating the tree and coughing. That's when I listen to the Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
Okay.
Much to my daughter's, you know.
Dismay.
Dismay or
chagrin.
Holy
fuck.
Let's do this.
Well, what's better than TSO during Christmas? THO during Christmas.
THC during Christmas.
THOs. Woo! TDRs, remember?
I forgot.
THOs?
Oh, wow. Remember that?
Anyway, TSO, THO, THC. They're all awesome.
Good stuff for presents. Great presents.
All three.
For your friends.
All three. So here's my fourth. This is taking a while.
And we're going to talk in double time. Go!
No, I can't do that. This is one I actually believe in, and this is one that, you know, I brought into the realm of the Kuhn Top 5. This is my boy Mike Ferris, Screaming Cheetah Wheelie's lead singer, Grammy winner, gospel singer, Grammy for gospel singing. Every year in Nashville, for about 10 years now, since he's been sober, the guy's incredible. He's even better sober than he was.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
I wonder if we would be.
No, we'd suck.
All right, let's go keep going with Mike.
Anyway, I love this guy. I hope he watches. Every year in Nashville, he does a concert for 2 nights. And it's a Christmas special. And he's got, like, honestly, he's got, like, these 3 incredible, huge black women on stage that are, like, the best background singers. You understand what I'm saying?
Gospel shit.
Right? And he's got, like, the greatest musicians behind him. We missed it again this year.
That's what I wanted comes to up so quick. Christmas.
Yeah.
I couldn't do it.
Really?
Yeah.
It comes really up so quick every year. He announces it in like November and it comes up in December or a couple months and it's so tough. We're going to get there, Mike. I promise. You know I love you. So here's White Christmas from Mike Ferris's show.
Gospel rock.
It's rock and roll blues.
Rock and roll blues.
This is where it all came from. Listen to this.
And, it's got everything.
Yeah, no. This is going to make you want to look up more of Mike's stuff. Feel it. All right? Here's White Christmas. That should have been our last
one. Oh, that's a great song.
To end with. It should have been our last one.
It's definitely, man, gets you going.
I love that, man.
So,
I swear.
And just so you guys know, Mike Ferris and Derek Davis from Babylon AD, his solo stuff from that he does, that's my Sunday music. That's like my gospel. That's my Sunday music.
I
listen
like
to Mike Ferris, and I listened to
Derek's soul stuff.
Yeah, his revolutionary souls stuff, and yeah. That's my two. I told Derek that. I've never told Mike that because I've never met him. But
That's a bucket list. I've seen Screamin' Cheetah Willies twice, but I've never met them or Mike. And God bless that dude. He fucking rules.
So I'm gonna
look him up.
I'm gonna save my cheesy one for last. So I'm gonna go with this one because this one's cool. It involves Lemmy from Motorhead, Billy Gibbons from ZZ Top, and Dave Grohl from I want to say Foo Fighters because I don't want to. You know, Nirvana.
That N-word. It's the N-word in our world.
So
what are you talking about?
They rocked out. They got on stage. Dave plays with everybody.
Little Nirvanas?
What?
Those damn Nirvanas.
Dave Grohl plays with everybody, and everybody Dave plays with thinks he's cool. We've never met Dave Grohl, but he's somebody I'd love to hang out with because he seems like he's cool as shit. Everybody loves Billy Gibbons. I saw the episode of the Sammy Hagar show.
I'd rather hang out with Billy Gibbons.
That Sammy Hagar show that Bill he did, he hung out with Billy Gibbons and they had a blast. They both seemed super cool.
I'd rather hang out with Lemmy.
Lemmy is fucking Lemmy. He wants to
hang out with Lemmy.
Right.
No,
right. Yeah, so take about 12 feet and you can hang out with Lemmy.
Six.
This is. Well, I think
it's very 12 feet.
Fucking six? Have you ever seen it when graves actually get dug?
There was an HBO show called 6 Feet Under for a reason.
Yeah, I don't really think it's 6 feet.
Well, not New Orleans because they start floating.
Yeah.
Floating in my own shoes.
This is Run, Run, Rudolph, and it's a killer version. Again, I'm not a huge fan of these remakes of rock songs, but when you have three rock stars like this from like three different types of music genres, if you want to call them that, I use that word too much, but this song rules.
Okay, let's listen.
Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gonna make it to town. Santa making merry, telling me he can take the freeway down. Run, run, Rudolph, I'm feeling like you're married around. Said Santa to a boy child, what have you been longing for? All I want for Christmas is a rock and roll electric guitar. And then away you went, Rudolph, whizzing like a shooting star.
My last awesome Kuhn, Jim Kuhn, top five. I said Kuhn, the other one, but we're
just in case you thought it was me that was giving this one.
Well, Spinal Tap, right? All of heavy metal's favorite parody band, but not making fun of what we love.
Not Steel Panther?
Not Steel Panther.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Steel Panther.
This is actually quality musicians that write quality songs with quality lyrics, and they're in their 70s now. Late 60s, 70s. Penny Marshall died today.
Oh, I didn't hear about that.
You didn't know that?
No.
She was 75. Bless Penny. Laverne DeFazio.
Yeah.
Right? And her counterpart was Lenny. From Lenny and the Squig Tones. Right?
Right.
So they're about the same age. So I know that Michael McKean, Lenny.
No, he wasn't Lenny.
Yeah, he was Lenny in Spinal Tap.
Oh, yeah, they don't want Squiggy. Yeah, Squiggy.
Hello, Laverne. I just wanted to do that. Thank you.
Very nice.
Hello, Pete. So anyway.
Wow, he's so much older than me.
So anyway, here's Spinal Tap, the real original parody band who turned into
a
Hall of Fame, my Hall of Fame real band, who we've seen twice. We've seen them play with Ozzy at the Ozzy Osbourne, one of the Ozfest. Some Ozfest in Phoenix.
Yeah.
Or Mesa, whatever. And we saw the Electric Acoustic Reunion show here in Denver.
And we go see them again.
And we have pics from all these guys, and they're great. I go see them again in a second. And here is Christmas with the Devil. It's a hilarious live video that is extremely entertaining and will blow you away more than any of that stupid parody heavy metal shit that we know of today.
All right.
Right? Spinal Tap.
Yeah.
All right. Tap into America, motherfuckers. Right?
Yeah, that's right.
Tap into America.
Tap into America is what we say.
All right.
All right, my last one is
I'm done.
It's a rock and roll song, but it's not a rock and roll song. And it's actually from a movie. And I started watching this movie 10 years ago with my daughter because it was funny.
It was actually a book.
It was a book. It started off as a book, and the book is nothing like the movie. The book is like a real children's book. It's like a book for kinder and first graders, right?
Kinder.
Kindergarten.
Oh, that's so cute. You say kinder because you're a teacher.
Yeah, I do. And so the book's called Olive.
Oh, I'm not supposed to say
Olive the Other Reindeer.
Cigarette. English cigarette. I was talking about
the
British.
I bet you were. Yes. The book's called Olive the Other Reindeer, and so is the movie. The movie, however, was done by Matt Groening of The Simpsons.
It's very
Simpsons-like.
So
he definitely changed the book to be more.
And they just turned 30 years old this week also.
So there's kids love it, but there's so many adult references that kids won't get in it. It makes it perfect.
It's called
what? My favorite Christmas movie, Olive the Other Reindeer.
Tell our friends.
And the voices star, Jay Moore is one of the voices. He's great. In it.
M-O-H-R. Where has he been? He
does a sports show.
He still does? Jay Moore is one of the funniest fucking
he's
guys.
He's a funny comedian guy.
He's on this.
There's a whole bunch of stars. One of the Saturday Night Live guys that did, oh my god.
Back in the day?
He plays, I'm not going to even tell you. You got to watch the movie. Anyway, the song is Big Bad Voodoo Daddy, and it features a very unusual vocalist because she's the voice of Olive in the movie, and that would be the great actress who I've always had the hots for, Drew Barrymore.
Yeah.
Okay? And so the song is called Merry Christmas After All.
Pedophile. Pedophile.
He's a pedophile. As an adult, ever since she did that movie with Adam Sandler,
Fifty First Dates.
I just love Drew Barrymore. And
he liked her in E.T. is what he really
shut
liked.
Up.
When and he I watches it now, woo! Look out, get out of the room.
Erectile dysfunction.
I don't understand.
E.T.?
Oh, that's terrible.
Thank you. No, be terrible.
It's like Peterphile over here. I think that's what
that'll be cut out, but what you will see right now.
Oh, it won't.
No. This is Merry Christmas After All.
Big Bad Voodoo Daddy.
Yeah, Big Voodoo
Daddy. And we'll be back after you rock with this somewhere.
Maybe music news, right?
Okay, we'll come back.
All right, we'll do that.
Maybe.
I don't have antlers, I don't have hooves. How flying works, I have no clue. But now I've got the reindeer moves. I'm a true blue member of the crew.
Good to call it to remind us. You can't give up on Christmas Eve. Now the trouble's all behind us, 'cause I've taught us how to believe. So Merry Christmas after all, to everybody being small.
I pulled the sleigh and had a ball.
So Merry Christmas after all.
Shows our sponsor Wolfpack Productions. If every city had a Wolfpack Productions, you'd get great concerts like we have.
Here's Wolfpack shows coming up New Year's Eve, right around the corner after Christmas. Let's let some steam out, let the holidays go. New Year's Eve, we got Jacob Cade and Jed Blow playing at Herman's.
You know, we love Jacob, man.
And we do. And I'm not going to mention the venues for these. You'll see them up on the board here. We got Dokken on 1-4, January 4th, rocking with Dokken. And Don Dokken, the classic, the man, the myth.
Mick Brown.
The legend. Steelheart. I spit every time so far. Steelheart on January 19th.
As opposed to the same band, with a terrible band with the same name, Steel Panther, who's playing the same night. Go see Steelheart.
They'll be at a different venue, sucking cock. Okay, so Steelheart will be with me.
Hanging out.
On 119, hanging out, rocking.
We'll talk about them.
And Mike Tramp's coming on February 17th, and I expect you all to be there to see me and Pete and Mike, and you'll see me cry during his show. And
there's more. I know you're going to cry.
7, 6.
I got more.
5.
We got Red Dragon Cartel 3-5, Winger 3-8, and XYZ 3-9. Be there. Holy
be
fuck.
Be there. Go
it's
to all the Wolfpack shows.
A week of rock. Holy shit.
Oh, man. It's ridiculous. And that's only the first, 3 months of the year. It's going to be ridiculous. Faster Pussycat, Bang Tango.
Hang in there. It's going to be a ride.
8/16. That's not until August, but I can't wait to see Faster Pussycat and Bang Tango. The shows that these guys announced.
Strap it on. It's going to be a ride.
Strap it on for the Wolfpack ride.
Oh.
Kuhn Rockcast music news segment. Okay, Peter and I often get together and do our news segments so we don't clash. Today we clashed on a few segments because we didn't talk about it first.
We try not to talk about stuff first because we want to make the show spontaneous. Boom!
Okay, so here goes nothing. No, just kidding.
That was spontaneous. Very spontaneous.
All right,
of you.
So check this out. M3 hired LA Guns to play for M3 in March of 2019.
Yeah, they're one of the top acts.
May 3rd through 5th.
Merriweather Pavilion, you should go to see because there's a lot of great bands playing.
Right! So check this out. We all know now that it's not really the real LA Guns. Well, it's not Tracy. Well, you know what?
You have so much couth.
You know what, though? I'm wrong. It's not Tracy and Phil.
Right.
But it is Steve Riley's version of LA Guns, and he does own half of the naming rights of LA Guns, according to him.
Yep, and he does.
Okay, well then, LA Guns is playing M3. Who's in the band, Pete?
Kelly Nichols.
Wow, bass player Kelly Nichols?
No, yeah, Kelly Nichols is playing.
Who else is playing?
Scott Griffin?
Scotty Griffin. Bass player Scotty Griffin?
He's
Scotty Griffin.
He's playing guitar.
What?
He's gonna be playing guitar.
What? Yeah.
He's the guitar player.
Yeah. Scotty, guitar. Bass players don't play guitar.
Hey, he tweeted that he's learning all the songs.
Bass players don't play guitar. That's a rule. You
he
know
says
that.
He was a guitar player before.
From a bass player to you, you know that. You know that.
All right.
Shame on you, Scotty.
Shame on
you. But what I do remember about you, Scotty Griffin, is when you guys played LA Guns when you were with Phil and the guys before Tracy, and you played the casino up here in
Central City.
Yeah,
Blackhawk,
and somebody farted so bad.
Oh, yeah.
And I thought, remember, it was like one of the worst farts.
Oh my god.
It was the worst smells in the world.
I can't believe
and
that.
And Scotty on stage actually was like, what the fuck is that? So here's to you, brother.
Oh, that's hilarious.
And who else is in the band? We got vocalist Jacob Bunton.
Okay.
And he's been with Adler and Lyman.
So he can sing.
Yeah, the guy can sing.
Out of
so
band.
It's probably going to be a pretty good version of a band, but it's not LA Guns. But okay, they'll be playing some LA Guns songs, they'll be playing some covers and some other ones.
You're being so nice about this.
I am. What's your view?
My view is this is bullshit.
Okay, what do you got?
I got that Phil Lewis is the voice of LA Guns. Tracy Guns is the one of the originators of guitar players, as is Phil.
Are you like... These guys are trying to make a living here.
Okay.
Honestly, no, wait, the interview's...
No, here's the deal. Steve Riley's not even an original member. He is credited with playing drums on the first album.
Well, he's on the first recorded album.
No, we're... What's his name?
I don't have it down here.
You wrote it down for me.
No, I didn't.
Yes,
I
wrote his name down. There's an original drummer of LA Guns, and his name is Nicky Beats Alexander. And he actually played on the first LA Guns album.
What the fuck about Nicky Alexander?
Well, I'm saying is Steve Riley, he may own 50%, but he's not LA Guns. And for him, this is rat. This is fucking rat all over again.
Now, you know what,
this is Bobby Blotzer doing the same thing as Steve Riley.
So Steve's interview was like all about...
Or Steve Riley, I'm sorry.
Steve was like, he was, not pleading, but he was describing with everybody like, hey, you know what, we make some royalties from our albums and stuff. He goes, but our real money, our making a living is playing live shows. There's no doubt about it. He goes, I'm just trying to make a living, trying to make a life.
So form a new band. You've got a great band behind you.
Yeah,
a lot of great people. Form a new band, write some new songs, kick ass.
Because forming a new band is such a great
idea
these days.
No, I'm not going to go to M3 just because of this bullshit.
I wasn't going anywhere.
No, I wasn't going anywhere.
You didn't even want to do it. Okay.
Lita Ford. So Lita Ford says a full reunion of the Runaways is not going to happen, and she actually blames Joan Jett's manager for the whole thing. And we met Lita Ford once. We got a picture. I met her for about 13 seconds.
Her guitar player was nice.
She was really sweet. And
Patrick was
Patrick,
nice.
Patrick, her guitar player, is super cool.
Kennison.
Yep, great guy. He hung out with us and
thought I was in Babylon 80. Really?
Yeah,
nice
he did. You really
because I was hanging out with him.
Oh, yeah, right.
He's like, are you the bass player?
That's funny. That's funny. So, anyway,
that could have been a bit, though.
This is never going to happen, and she wants the band to get back together, but she says that that Joan Jett's controlled by her manager, and that that he won't ever let it happen, that he hates her, and so the Runaways reunion, and I mean, I love Cherry Bomb, and I love Joan Jett, and I love Lita Ford music.
Couldn't care less about a reunion, though.
No, I think it'd be super cool. I think it'd be really cool. I'd go see
them. I was going to say if they're naked, but no.
Not anymore?
That would be good.
You wouldn't want to see Lita Ford naked.
I have. No.
Okay. What's your next news segment then, tough guy?
Guess what?
What?
Kiss is in the news again. Yep. Kiss is in the news again, folks.
Really? All right.
What you got? What's your next
news
story?
That's it? Okay. I'm going to go back to the Runaways. Real quick, I forgot to tell you this. Former Runaways bassist Jackie Fox was on Jeopardy. She won $34,000 in 2 days.
I hope you appreciate me.
And I thought that was really, really cool. Five Finger Death Punch. Not a huge fan, but they are a killer rock and roll band that a lot of people love. And if you're watching the show and you like them, you should probably know that their drummer, Jeremy...
I'm going to do sign language.
Jeremy Spencer... hurt his back really bad, had surgery a bunch of times, and he can't play anymore. He's not going to be able to play anymore, and so he quit the band, but he wishes the band the best.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, and the band wishes him the best, and everybody's cool, and he's going to drum on.
The new drummer.
The new drummer.
Yeah.
And a new drummer. You're going to have some music.
That was fun.
We should do more music news.
Right. Oh my gosh.
New segment
coming up for deaf people. Music news for deaf people.
I love it. New
that
segment.
That was actually pretty good.
We are trying to come up with new segments for the new year.
And there you have
some
it.
Really good ideas.
And there you have
and
it.
That one just.
Starting out with Five Finger Death Punch. What's the real news? The drummer left the band because he's like physically incapable of drumming anywhere because since he was 6 years old, he's been drumming.
We heard the story already.
Okay, good. Yeah, All right. And I have my last. Oh, I hit myself. My last music news story for today, this Christmas special edition. Thank you for joining us, by the way. Ya-da-da-da, authorized biography of King's X due in February. Okay, did you hear that? So the authorized biography of King's X is due in February. Ken?
We have a friend named Ken, and maybe...
We have a viewer, and his name is Ken. And I'm doing this for you, brother. King's X is coming out with a biography in February, and I'm not looking at the camera because I'm reading this. I want to get this right. It's King's X, the oral history. Peter could have a whole fucking book on that, but we won't go there. Hey,
who are you?
Oh, hey! Oh, bail!
What did I do?
So check this out. So, this is the... Oh my gosh, I copied the wrong shit. Ty Tabor, Jerry Casco. Okay, so the three members, Doug Pinnick, bass player, singer, guitarist.
And I'm loving you.
And when as a bass player, fake singer, not so happy about. Ty Tabor, who's the guitar player, yep. And drummer Jerry Gaskill, very awesome. Yep. They're gonna tell their first full story for the whole time. And here's the cool, well, there's a lot of guest members on the video, and I'll name them. Wow, I'm going to die here in a second. Pearl Jam's Jeff Ament, Andy Summers from The Police, Billy Corgan, Kim Thayil from Soundgarden, Rex Brown, Pantera, and Mick Mars, and lots more. And the cool thing about this is King's X, the oral history. When I say the oral history, that's really bad.
Yeah, the same sentence.
So if you really King's X, the oral history, they go behind the scenes of every single song the band has ever recorded. I'm not kidding. This video has, they talk about every single set song.
So it's like 17 hours long.
At least. Or they just say yes, no, it was okay, it was good, it was good, it was good, it was good, it was bad, good. Check this out though. If it was coming out before Christmas, Ken, I'd buy it for you for a Christmas present. But since it's not, good luck. I hope it's awesome.
Yeah. All right. So
I do love
We them. Love the band Lies, Deceit, and Treachery. And if you know who they are, and if you don't, they are three of the four original members of the
Bullet Boys. Shout out to Kuhn Bros.
The Bullet Boys. And so it's Lonnie Vincent, it's Mick Sweda,
Jimmy
DeAnda, and, well, originally Mark Torian, when they were the Bullet Boys, and then now there lies Deceit and Treachery, and they've had a couple of different singers, and one of them right now is Andrew Freeman.
Oh, I was thinking of Shane.
And we'll talk about Shane in a second.
Sorry, no, I was actually thinking about Shane, but you're right, Andrew Freeman is the current
singer. Andrew's the current singer, and...
And they've talked to him, and they have determined what they're going to do in 2019?
Yeah, they're going to try to record some new music. So Andrew's really busy. He... plays with
Last in Line. It's not a Dokken tribute band. It's not a Dokken cover. Or Dokken. It's not a
Dio.
Dio. I knew it was a Dio. Yeah. It's not a Dio cover band. It's not a Dio tribute band. It is a Last in Line. They are their own band with a bunch of
original
Dio members.
And Andrew Freeman sings for them. And, so
and he's not letting them
It's not a cover band.
And he's not letting
it Because we heard someone say that to him and he got upset. Though he's a really cool guy and we really like him. So,
very cool.
This is how talented he is. He sings for Last in Line. He's also sang for Offspring, Seven Dust, Stain, Shadows Fall, Power Man 5000, Dope, Nonpoint, Head PE, Lacuna Coil.
What'd you have for dinner?
Pizza. Lynch Mob. He played on a lot of Lynch Mob tours. The guy sang on him. He's just amazing. And they're going to try to do some new music together. But he has to fit it in with all his other
stuff. But he committed to it enough to where they... talked about it online.
Nope. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And we'll talk about the bedtime story maybe next week even English? About... I'm not even going to talk about Shane tonight.
We love Shane.
Shane was their singer of the Lies, Deceit, and Treachery before.
He knows us personally.
Andrew and Shane... And Shane is a great guy. We've hung out with Shane, had dinner and stuff. And we have a really cool bedtime story
about
Shane and his life. But we're going to do that next week because we have a different bedtime story tonight and I don't want
it
too
deep. It includes sunglasses.
And it's not music news. It includes sunglasses.
Oh, glasses. That's a tease for you. Not that sunglasses are a big tease.
Well, glasses in general.
It's fun. Yeah. It's fun. All right, those
Speak
are some
of
fun
shot glasses.
Oh, wait.
Is that it for music news? Do you want to talk about Def Leppard? Let's talk about two other things real quick.
Okay, I'm done with my list.
Def Leppard Hall of Fame, right? They released a Christmas song recently, and it's horrible. It's not as horrible as the other one I've heard, but it's really
When was it recorded, P?
I don't even know.
Really?
But it's on their new the story so far, like CD.
I can't imagine Def Leppard trying. We don't need to make this a long conversation, but I can't imagine Def Leppard coming out with anything new that I would think is acceptable at all.
It sounds fine. It's just I don't like.
If it was made in the last 5 years, it's probably horrendous.
And again, you know me, Def Leppard's first three albums, and I'm done.
Yeah, it would have to be way overproduced and just horrendous.
But there's the worst Christmas song that was released in the last couple of weeks. There, Jim. You want to know what it is?
Does it have to do with Bruce Springsteen?
No.
Who else do I despise?
No, you don't despise this guy. He's actually was a great singer from a band who left, and now a Filipino replaced him.
Oh. Did Steve Perry come out? I didn't listen to it. I saw.
Bad.
Steve Perry came out and released a new Christmas song. He's going to tell you about it. Review.
Well, it's
I didn't listen to it because I figured
I'm not going
to
review it. I'm just going to tell you his version of Have Yourself a... Brianna, my daughter, came out and she goes, that sounds horrible because I was listening to it tonight. Just
And that's an honest 14-year-old.
And I go, yeah, you're right. She goes, I'm glad you picked it. I go, baby, that's the guy who sings Don't Stop Believing. She goes, really?
And you said, yeah.
What happened?
He does. And you said he died 20 years ago.
No, I love Steve Perry. I really do. But wow, some of the new Christmas songs that are coming out didn't make our list. But you can listen to them. That's our music news segment. Every night.
His music.
And, so listen to this actual...
got a killer personal story coming up.
Yeah, about this whole thing.
With my boy Miljenko Milosevic. Lover.
Steelheart, right? Yeah, that all right, check this out.
Why don't you sit right back and I may tell you a tale.
Shit. You ready? Get out of your covers. right? Put your hand under your elastic strap on your waistband and just get ready for the kitty to, get ready for the kitties to come
snuggle,
up and
snuggle. Or dog, or whatever.
Yeah, because we got a kitty.
Squirrel, if you like have squirrels.
It used to be dog, now it's kitties.
Yeah.
But, bedtime story for you.
Our bedtime story involves one of our favorite rock stars.
She's
coming back to Denver very soon with Steelheart. And he is the voice of Steelheart and Steel Dragon. Mealy.
Yeah, it's Miljenko Manajevic.
Yep, that's it.
That's actually it.
You do it.
I did, for the first time in my life, Manajevic. Mealy!
We love you.
And here's a story about my brother.
So,
because of our affiliation with
Wolfpack Productions, we had the opportunity to pick up.
It wasn't just the opportunity, it was my brother.
Anthony.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say
Anthony and Jim.
I wasn't going to say
no,
that. I was just going to say
the boys.
Okay. Yeah, they allowed me to pick up Mealy from the airport, and they crossed their fingers that I wouldn't pull a fucking fanboy shit.
Yeah,
right. I was so nervous. This is part of the story.
Did you shit yourself?
No, I asked you to go with me.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You did.
I was like already, I live 10 minutes from fucking DIA.
The airport, right?
Yep, and I'm like, no problem. I can go get Mealy whenever. I'll take the day off
Pete,
of work.
Pete,
go with me. I'm like, Pete, I'm sweating so much. I just took a shower and I'm fucking sweating through my deodorant and antiperspirant. I was so nervous. I'm like, go with me. Please go with me.
And they're like,
I'm like, I'll come and fucking get you.
Right.
In the opposite direction for 30 minutes.
Away, right, back and forth.
So I drove 30 minutes to get him, and we drove an hour back to get to the airport. And it was like, he was the sweetest man. And he walks, you know, through the... And I'm picturing him. I'm picturing Todd. I'm picturing all the people that we picked up.
Before.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I am. And
he walks through the...
And he goes up, and we were texting because Wolfpack gave Mealy my phone number. So he's like, hey, it was very cool. He's like, hey, I'll be here this time. And I emailed him back. I said, I'll be there a half hour early waiting for you. So he went up to Mealy went up to the podium asking for me, and I actually saw him, spotted him. So I went in, and I said, I'm the guy you're looking for.
Went in the bathroom, he cleaned up, he came back.
No, I cleaned up before.
Okay.
But we went and sat by the carousel waiting for his bag.
Right.
And we
just chatted and just talked.
We talked old school steel art with Jim Ward, the bass player. We talked all sorts of cool stuff that
And then on the ride back, we talked about his accident in Denver.
And we talked about their original drummer that
passed away.
And he was great about that.
He was so honest.
Was so cool.
So, but yeah, remember the whole conversation about how, like, thanked him to coming back for Denver.
Yep.
Denver,
and he wanted to make well, right? He wanted to... His whole reason for being here that weekend was to make amends with Denver. Because he had such... That one show with Denver where...
Scaffolding fell on him and almost killed him.
At McNichols Arena. Then it took many years for him to come back. And we were actually at his first show when he came back. It was at the Grizzly Rose, I believe.
Yep.
And then several years later...
Country Bar, but they had rock bands. It was All Night Rain.
Oh, they had great, incredible concerts that I'll never forget at the Grizzly Rose. But we talked to Maui... Mealy about this.
Maui is because of the chocolate.
Yeah, it's exactly. Oh my God, it says Maui.
So here's to Maui.
I was like, where'd that come from? Here's to you, Mealy.
So yeah, so
we talked to him about making amends with Denver, and I ended up, thanks to Wolfpack, I ended up being his personal driver, him and his girlfriend,
right,
for the whole weekend until Peter. Oh my God, I pick up Mealy from the airport. Okay, I drive him back to his hotel.
And I'm in the car too. We're all chatting. And that's where he played us the Christmas song.
Oh, that's the whole point of this fucking story.
That's the whole point
you
of the
idiots.
Story.
Remind
Dummy.
Us, you fucking idiot.
Yeah, why don't you remind us, Rock and Ron? Who has no idea what's going on right now.
Okay, so we're going back from the airport, and Mealy brings up his phone, and he's like, put me on Bluetooth. So I put him on Bluetooth, which didn't work at the time, but let's just assume that I put him on Bluetooth. And we listen to this. He goes, here's a new Christmas song I have. It's coming out in a couple months. I haven't released it yet.
Right, it's a remake. But it wasn't one of the ones you just heard.
It was
Chestnuts.
You've never heard it because he's never released it.
It's Chestnuts Roasting of his version.
He was the most
crooner.
He was,
we were freaking out. It was like Sinatra.
That's exactly
Mealy.
Right. I told him, oh my god, this is fucking cool. I said to Mealy, I go, well, you're a fucking crooner. And he's like, hell yeah, I am. He actually, like, he's like, yeah, I am. What do you think I am? And I was trying to remember the other guy's name, the guy, like, not the Sinatra.
Harry Connick Jr.
I love Harry Connick Jr. And that's, I was trying to say, you sound like Harry Connick Jr. And he got offended because he thinks he's better than Harry Connick
right.
Jr.
Right, so I call him Mealy Sinatra.
Yeah, so that was incredible. So he played us a song that he recorded with an orchestra that hasn't been released. And we were here, and he has these two songs on steelheartstore.com. It's his Hallelujah song and another Christmas song that I have to go home and find it. But the guy's incredible. And what else were you going to say about
the only thing I was going to say was, like, so you were right. We pick him up.
I drove him to sound check.
All the way back. So sound check, the whole thing, back to the hotel. And
back
then he
to
goes,
sound check, back to the hotel. It
and
was
then
crazy.
He goes, but then he's like, well, my girlfriend's coming in and I got to get her an Uber and he's really upset, like, because he's like feeling like, oh man, my girlfriend's coming in from, because it was coming in from a different city.
So Mealy was going to pay for a taxi
or Uber to get her here.
From the airport to downtown.
I was
like 50 minutes.
I had to go pick up my truck at Jim's anyway, whatever. You know, I'll pick her up.
He's like, really? You sure?
You sure? And I'm like, no problem.
Totally. I mean, from Mealy's point of view, it was like, totally shady. He's probably like risking a lot, right?
But I think he thought like,
oh,
wow,
you're totally cool.
He loved hanging out and loved those. Right. He's like, I feel safe with this guy.
So he gives his girlfriend's phone number to you.
Yeah.
Most gorgeous
Sarah
girl in the world.
Model.
Sarah.
Oh my god. Just a model. Stunning.
What a sweetheart.
And a sweetheart.
I mean, a weekend of knowing each other.
Gives my number. So now I have Mealy and Sarah Ann's phone numbers in my phone.
So here's the really cool part of the story. That I'm glad I'm not that Pendleton to tell you.
PMS tonight, baby.
So I drop Mealy off. I pick him up at his hotel with his girlfriend, Sarah, and I bring him to the show. And I drop him off, and I say, hey, man, before we go, I just want to let you know, before I drop you off here, I just want to let you know this has been a dream for me the last 3 days, driving you around. I love you. I think you're fantastic. I just wanted to let you know that I appreciate it. And say, but you know, before we leave, and he looks at me and goes, what are you gonna dish us in the middle of the show?
Right, are you gonna leave?
Are you gonna leave us in the show? And I go, no, I don't plan on it. And he goes, well, we're doing shots after the show.
So we end up backstage, of course.
So we end up backstage after the show. This is how awesome he is.
Yeah, did you actually do a shot of tequila?
Yeah, I did.
You did, you never.
No, I did a shot of rum.
Oh, rum.
Because
right.
He had rum and tequila.
And I
chose
tequila,
the rum.
You did rum.
But he was so nice, he wouldn't let me leave without being gracious. And we ended up backstage. We ended up being friends with Mark, his tour manager, and the whole band.
Yeah, Mike Hunger, just a great guy. Joe.
Joe Pesci. And Mealy.
Incredible.
And the tour manager.
Yeah, they're
so
all
sweet.
Great guys.
So I drove Mealy and his girlfriend back to
Martin Anderson. You always forget Martin
Anderson.
I do. This is like the fourth fucking show. You forgot Martin Anderson.
Martin, I love you and your makeup. I love you and your makeup.
So we're hanging out. We're having a blast with them. And what does Mealy give you?
He gives me a bottle of whiskey. After driving him around all weekend, I drop him off at his hotel room downtown at like the beautiful Marriott. And he's like, here, take your pick. And he holds out a bottle of regular whiskey, locally brewed, that somebody gave him brewed, distilled. And a cinnamon whiskey that was locally distilled from the same place. And he goes, take your pick.
Top quality, too.
He goes, take your pick, man. And I looked at it for like 2 seconds. He goes, I'm serious. I'm like, ooh, I grabbed the good shit.
Yeah.
I grabbed the non...
Right. He was giving away both anyways.
Yeah, he's like, yeah. He's like,
take him back on the...
He's like, here, Jim, take a whiskey. And I grabbed one. And Mealy, you're the most gracious celebrity...
Rockstar.
South Korean,
you know,
celebrity.
From the movie Rockstar.
Oh, yeah.
He is
that
a rock
guy.
Star. He's a fucking rock star.
He's the singer in the movie Rockstar.
And he is.
That Mark.
Truly.
That Mark.
Marky Mark. Mark
Marky
Wahlberg.
Mark Wahlberg's movie.
That's we love you. We can't wait to see you back in Denver. And all of you come to Denver for a Wolfpack show.
I'm going to tag you, Mealy. I'm going to tag you and watch
love,
the last 30 seconds of this.
Feel the love
show.
Of the bedtime story that we just told. What? Thank you guys so much for watching our show.
Thank you, he said.
Just our silliness, our funness, our festiveness here on
I had a friend in the elementary
here
school.
Here we go.
His name was John Garland. And here's Peter Garland.
Yeah.
His pedophile lover.
Okay.
Yes.
So, hey, watch this next week. We're going to do a special... Get this crap off of me. It's just...
Oh, I like it.
We are going to watch a show... you're going to watch a show next week that has us, again, on Decibel Geek TV. Guess what? It's going to be a New Year's Eve show. So you're going to see maybe some live stuff. I don't know. Maybe some...
Oh, you know what? We're thinking about...
What are we thinking about?
Well, I forgot what we're...
Don't lie to the people.
I'm not. You're babbling just to waste time. And I'm actually... New Year's Eve, Jacob Cade at Herman's Hideaway.
And that's where we're going to be.
We're thinking about going live and doing a live broadcast from there. We're thinking about doing all sorts of shit for the weekend. And we got some stuff coming up next week that will surprise me, because I don't even know what it is.
No, you don't know. No. You don't know anything.
You don't know. Nope. I know nothing at all.
Nothing. And then next year, we actually do have some stuff that we both know that we're going to do next year that are different.
That we're really excited about.
That we're kind of excited about. Oh. So stay tuned. Maybe we'll give you a hint for the New Year's show. Thanks for joining us for episode 17. 18 is next week. We can't believe it's...
And you never know what episode...
Madness. Wait.
Hold on, folks.
Oh, wait. Hey, guys, you remember this guy from, like, when we do the headphone...
Wow.
Yeah. You know?
Remember Ron?
Remember Rockin' Ron?
He's the one that pays my bills.
Yeah. Or rubs your balls.
One or the other. It costs me the same.
All right, before we sign off, I just want to thank all the viewers for the past... 17 episodes on behalf of Decibel Geek TV. 17
already?
17.
Jesus. Thanks to
this fucking
guy.
You're going to be legal next week.
No, not only that, but when we started, he had a full head of hair. It was, okay, 10 years ago.
Yeah, go back to episode 1. Yeah, it was just like, psh.
Holy
Thank fuck. You, everybody. Have a heavy Christmas. No, metal.
Metal
heavy? Christmas and a heavy New Year.
I love it.
I just like to poke him in the belly.
Rock and roll with your music.
And love your brothers.
Love your brothers and love your...
Oh, he did the kissing. Wow. He did the reverse kiss thing.
Are you kidding me?
What the hell?
Wow.
I love you, Ron.
You were thinking about that all week.
Trying to get back at us for like a week or two.
Holy fuck. Cheers to you and your kisses.
That is great.
Take care, everybody. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Thank you. Kuhn Brothers.
Go take a shower.
Thank you, guys.
See you next week.
Yeah, go take a shower.
I'll wash my face. Yeah.
Yeah.
A very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Let's hope it's a good one without any fear. And so this is Christmas. And for poor ones, the world is so wrong. And so happy Christmas for black and for white, for yellow and red ones. Let's start.